Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to design and create a powerful movie poster in the film noir style using a photo and custom smoke brushes from BrushEasy.com. I provided this Photoshop template so you can follow along. Its link is located in my video's description or project files. It includes this movie credits layer and a black background. The link to the smoke brushes I'll be using is also in my video's description. Before we begin, I want to mention that I'll be moving a bit faster for more advanced users. Open a photo you'd like to use for your poster. I downloaded this one from dreamstime.com. The first step is to make a selection around your subject to separate it from its background. For this photo, I'll use the pen tool. I did an in-depth tutorial on the pen tool, so if you'd like to watch it, I provided its link as well. Once you've selected your subject, click the layer mask icon to make a layer mask of the selection. We'll convert our image into a smart object so we can modify it non-destructively. Click the icon at the upper right corner and click Convert to Smart Object. If you're using version CS6 or later, go to Filter, Blur Gallery, and Tilt Shift. If you're using an earlier version, I'll mention a workaround in a minute. I did an in-depth tutorial on the Tilt Shift filter, which I included the link to as well. Press and hold Shift as you rotate the lines until they snap vertically. Rotate the dial in the center until your image is blurred along the edges approximately this much. Then, click OK at the top. If you're using a version earlier than CS6, you can use your Blur tool. Make sure the strength is 100%. Click your image. When you see this message, it's just telling you that the smart object must be rasterized before you can use the Blur tool. Click OK and adjust your tool size with your bracket keys. Make sure your caps lock key is off. Now, brush over the edge of your subject to blur it. If you're using CS6 or later, let's collapse the effects to save a little space. To place your subject onto the template I provided, press V to open your Move tool and drag it up to the tab of the template. Without releasing your mouse or pen, drag it down onto the template and release. To adjust its size, open your Transform tool by pressing Ctrl or Command T. When you see this message, just click OK. If your subject is larger than the document, your bounding box will be outside your canvas. To see your subject's entire bounding box, press Ctrl or Command 0. Go to a corner and press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag it in or out until the face is approximately this size. Drag it to the side to reveal half of the face. Then, press Enter or Return. To fit your document back onto your canvas, press Ctrl or Command 0. Next, we'll sharpen our subject. Go to Filter, Sharpen, and Unsharp Mask. I'll make the amount 190%, the radius 3 pixels, and the threshold 0. However, feel free to adjust this amount to sharpen it to your liking. I think I'd like to slide my subject down a bit. Click the adjustment layer icon and click black, white. Open the preset list and click High Contrast Blue Filter. Click the Credits layer and drag it to the top of the Layers panel. Make it visible and change its blend mode to Screen. Next, we'll add the poster's title. Open your Horizontal Type tool and pick a font. I'm using Pasta Palazzo Regular. If you'd like to use it, its link is in my video's description below. I'll make its size 567 points, but you can make it any size you like. I'll make the anti-aliasing sharp, right alignment, and white for its color. Click on your document and type out your text. To reposition it, open your Move tool and move it. If you want to add a second line of text with a different font, click on your document and pick the other font. I'll pick Bank Gothic Bold. I provided its link as well. Press Enter or Return and type out your text. Use your Move tool to move it. To adjust its size, use your Transform tool. To reposition the entire title, shift-click the other text layer to make it active as well, so you can reposition them together. Double-click an empty area of your top layer to open its layer style window. Click Bevel and Emboss. The style is inner bevel, the technique is chisel hard, and the depth is 50%. The direction is up, and the size is 4 pixels. Uncheck Global Light. The angle is 70 degrees, and the altitude is 20 degrees. The highlight mode is screen, the color is white, and the opacity is 100%. The shadow mode is multiply, its color is black, and its opacity is also 100%. Click Drop Shadow. The blend mode is multiply, the color is black, and the opacity is 50%. The angle is 60 degrees, the distance is 20 pixels, and the size is 10 pixels. Then click OK. To copy the effects to the other text, go to the FX symbol and press and hold Alt or Option as you drag a copy of it to the other text layer. Next, we'll create the smoky atmosphere with a custom smoke brush set from BrushEasy.com. After you install it, scroll to the bottom and make the background active. Click the New Layer icon to make a new layer above it. Let's name it Smoke. Make your subject active and change its blend mode to Overlay. The blend mode will make your subject look invisible for now, but once we add the smoke, it'll become visible again. Scroll to the top. Make both of your text layers active and change their blend modes to Overlay as well. To save space, let's place both text layers into a folder. Press Ctrl or Command G and name it. I'll name it Title. Scroll back down and make the smoke layer active. Make your foreground and background colors black and white respectively by pressing D on your keyboard. Invert the colors by pressing X. Now, white is your foreground color. Open your brush tool and brush picker. Click the gear icon and click the brush preset that I provided. I renamed the brushes Smoke Brushes 6, but they're exactly the same as the ones you downloaded. When you see this message, click OK to replace your current brushes with the new smoke brushes. Click the gear icon again and click Large Thumbnail. Notice the number under each smoke brush is over 4,500 pixels, which indicates that their sizes are huge. Click a brush. I'll type in 1,300 pixels and the opacity 45%, but feel free to experiment with these amounts. Click on various areas of your poster to start revealing your subject and the movie's title. Click on another brush, and if you want to change its angle, rotate the arrow on the dial. Reduce its size, and click on areas of your poster. If you want to hide areas of the smoke, click the layer mask icon to make a layer mask next to the smoke layer. Press X to invert your colors so black is your foreground color. Now, click on areas of the smoke that you'd like to hide or diminish. To better blend our movie title into the smoke, press V to open your Move tool, scroll to the top, and open your Movie Titles folder. Double-click Effects on the top text layer to open the blending options in the Layer Style window. In the Blend If Gray section, Alt-click or Option-click on the lower right icon of Underlying Layer. This will split it in two. Drag the left half of the icon to the left until the smoke is blended just enough with the text. You could also split the lower left icon and slide its right half over as well. Repeat the same steps for your other text. If you're using CS6 or later, scroll to the top and make the top folder active. Click the adjustment layer icon and click Color Lookup. Click 3D LUT and click LateSunset.3DL. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.